It looks like Alex Jones and Republican National Committee Chair Ronna McDaniel will be testifying in the Fulton County criminal trial against Donald Trump. And that's according to a new report that came out indicating that the judge in that case, Judge Scott McAfee, has granted prosecutor Fani Willis's request that the two provide testimony in that case. Now, she, Fani Willis, of course, is prosecuting the former president over his efforts to overturn the 2020 presidential election in Georgia. And on Tuesday, her office filed a petition specifically seeking testimony from Alex Jones and Ronna McDaniel, which the judge, of course, granted. He ruled that each is, quote, necessary and material. They're necessary and material witnesses in this prosecution and will, in fact, be required to be in attendance and testify. Now, let's start with McDaniel. Regarding Ronna McDaniel, McAfee wrote that she possesses unique knowledge concerning communications between herself and Donald Trump, as well as communications between herself and John Eastman regarding the conspiracy to cause certain individuals to falsely hold themselves out as the duly elected and qualified presidential electors. Eastman was also indicted along with Donald Trump in that case. Now, meanwhile, McAfee wrote that Alex Jones, quote, possesses unique knowledge concerning communications between himself and Kenneth Cheesebro and other known and unknown individuals involved in the multi-state coordinated efforts to influence the results of the November 3rd, 2020 presidential election in Georgia and elsewhere. Cheesebro has also been charged in that case. Like Trump and Eastman, he has pleaded not guilty. Cenk, any thoughts so far?
First of all, I'm never gonna not think the name Cheesebro is funny.
What about Ronna McDaniel?
Ronna McDaniel, also hilarious. When you got Ronna McDaniel and a Cheesebro, all you need is a side of fries and you're all good to go, okay?
Totally.
So, and instead they got a crazy shake, Alex Jones. They both make sense in terms of what the judge is ordering, because Ronna McDaniel is theoretically the head of the Republican Party. Obviously, in reality, it's Donald Trump, but she's the figurehead at the RNC. And if she had communications about how they were gonna try to steal the election with fake electors, yeah, we're gonna need your testimony. Maybe you don't have that. Maybe you don't have any emails, you don't have any texts, you don't have any phone calls, but that's why we're gonna need to hear from you, right? And if she's been implicated in other correspondence before, so let's see what you have to say. That's how justice works. And in terms of Alex Jones, I had read in the past about how he was involved in the planning of January 6th and was to help to facilitate it, etc. We'll find out what they know. What you don't need to rely on us. We'll get the actual facts in the courts. Now look, now they're just witnesses, right? If you call me as a witness for Bernie Sanders or someone else that didn't do anything wrong and you're doing trumped up charges against them, I can't wait to go. Yeah, call me as a witness, can't wait, okay? Now, if you did something wrong and the guy you're defending is definitely a criminal, then all of a sudden you're gonna be a little reluctant, okay? And so here we are. I mean, if you're Ronna McDaniel and Alex Jones and you guys are all innocent, you should be ecstatic at going and defending yourself and your beloved Donald Trump.
Now's your shot.
Yeah, have at it, Hoss. And Alex Jones, I mean, in a court setting where everything is dependent on actual evidence that you have to prove, you've done great. Oh, right, you've been terrible because you never have any evidence because you're a fraud and you lie for a living. Everything you say is a lie. That's why when you go to court, you get humiliated, the same as your beloved Donald Trump. So peas in a pod, enjoy the courtroom. That's where evidence matters. So let's see if you have any evidence, and you don't, other than ones that incriminate both of you.
Right, now keep in mind, Alex Jones and Ronna McDaniel have not been charged in this case. They're just being forced to testify due to the conversations they had with Trump and those in Trump's orbit. You know, the one thing that's really been bothering me about this entire case, whether you're talking about special counsel Jack Smith's prosecution of Donald Trump and you know, his co-conspirators, or Fani Willis's prosecution in Fulton County, Georgia. The fact that Senator Ron Johnson had his aide hand over the slate of fake electors to Vice President Mike Pence on January 6th, and he is not facing any charges for that whatsoever really bothers me.
Yeah, it's weird.
It's very strange, isn't it? And of course, he threw his aide under the bus. But like, who do you think your aide takes orders from, Ron Johnson? You think he acts, you know, on his own without you telling him to hand over the slate of fake electors?
I wonder if they're trying to, like, in their insane, weak Democratic minds, and Fani Willis has done a great job overall as far as we've seen, so I'll exempt her. But to be fair to Jack Smith too, Jack Smith has done an interesting job. I'm mainly talking about Merrick Garland and the other soft prosecutors. Maybe they thought like, oh, if we alienate Republican senators, maybe like if Trump is in charge, they'll vote with him. Well, I don't know. I don't know what your machinations are, but unless Ron Johnson is a cooperating witness, no, you should hold him accountable. You're never going to convince the Republican senators to do the right thing. 1997 called and would like their opinion back about whether you can have bipartisanship in a reasonable way with these guys. And even back then it wasn't reasonable, it was just corporate robbery, right? So, but in this case, no, they're gonna be diehards in favor of Trump no matter what you do. So if the guy was involved in a fake elector scheme, you should prosecute him. Anyone involved in that fake elector scheme was involved in a coup attempt and should definitely be prosecuted.
I mean, there's that image, like it's seared in my brain of the aide handing the slate of fake electors to Vice President Mike Pence. And to know that at least so far there are no consequences for the senator, it just blows my mind. But he should at least be forced to testify, because he clearly had conversations and he clearly knows things that I think would be worthy in that case. So we'll see how that plays out. But that's the biggest Trump fake electors related news that we've gotten this week so far. We'll update you if anything else develops. Anyway, Cenk, we've got 4 minutes left. Any more comments you want to read? Any other thoughts?
Sure. And what are we doing in the postgame, Anna, or bonus episode?
So in the bonus episode, we have a super cheery topic about how employees feel too guilty about calling in sick when they are sick. And then we're going to share you the outrageously high percentage of employers who think their employees are lying when they call out sick. So it'll be fun. I'm looking forward to it. You should too.
So tyt.com/join to get that bonus episode with the extra stories. And of course, you could hit the join button below. You could also upgrade through that button. All right, Don Whitehead wrote in something on Super Chat. The thing is, you take a chance. Sometimes good things happen. Sometimes bad things happen.
Usually bad things for us.
But if you take no chance, nothing happens.
That sounds pretty good.
No, that sounds terrible. Don, I'm 100% with you. And nothing happening right now means Donald Trump is going to get reelected president. At this point, things can change, and I hope things do change. But right now, if the election were held today, I'll put it this way, Donald Trump has at least a 90% chance of winning. Iceberg straight ahead. Okay, so we can't afford to do nothing. I'm with you, Don. How Blair, you wrote in, thank you so much for old school, Cenk. I needed that after a rough day of heavy news. Fun stories and lighthearted fun stories are my guilty pleasure on TYT. Me too. Look, we all love old school. I don't think we've done a great job of getting it out to as many people as we could, because it's such a fun show. But check it out, if you're a member, you can get all the old schools. You can watch them anytime you want. Again, tyt.com/join. And again, tomorrow we are going to have a significant announcement one way or another about whether I'm going to run or I'm not going to run, and yes, for president. So make sure you're checking out the show tomorrow. Rio Han writes in, they did this to my coworkers about the phishing. But if you fail a test, not only do you have mandated training, but they target you more intensely with phishing tests.
Oh, great.
That sounds amazing. Or Stone wrote in, the VP clearly is suffering from the princess syndrome. President Biden didn't help matters by putting her in charge of the border when you have a Secretary of Homeland Security to do that. The way that Biden threw Kamala Harris under the bus by putting her on border, an impossible border job. Okay, why did you pick her? Well, why did you pick her if you're gonna throw her under the bus?
Well, look, I'm starting to kind of change my mind on that, because I would have agreed with what you just said. But she also insisted on being in charge of the effort to do something about voting rights when she was warned, we're not gonna do anything about voting rights, so just how about you don't do that? And then they did nothing on voting rights, and she was left basically flat-footed on that.
No, look, there's no excuse. Kamala Harris has to be so much more active. And even if Biden is screwing you over, get out there and make an amazing, awesome case for the administration, because that's kind of your job. You really don't have anything else. That border job is nonsense. The viewer is right. The Homeland Security deals with that. The vice president has no power to deal with that. But go out there and make any case, every case. You can't find anything good in the administration that you can highlight?
She was a career prosecutor. This is not, she's not good at this. That's just the fact of the matter.
Make your case, for God's sake, any case. Fight against Trump, fight for yourself. We'll see you in the bonus episode.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.